بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم ما بعد. It is our yaqeen, it is our conviction that all halat, all conditions are from Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. A believer is happy with Allah's decision, no matter how sweet it may be or how bitter. When iman is in the making, a person will not look at the halat and conditions, but he will look at, in this condition, what is the command of Allah. We may not control conditions on earth, but we can control conditions under the earth. We may not control conditions now on earth, but under the earth, when we are departed, the key to that door is in our hands. That's why the people of Iman are constantly making effort on Iman. Luqman Hakim Rahmatullah alayhi used to say, "Man idha radhiya lam yukhrijhu ridahu ila al-batil." Three qualities when it is in a person: faqad istakmala al-iman, then his iman is complete, it is a good sign. Firstly, when a person is made happy by Allah, when condition come that is favorable to him, those conditions don't divert him to sin and guna and disobedience. Allah gave you tawfiq to earn wealth, you do not go to the places of evil. You bought a nice car, mashallah, you don't go to places of haram. So when good conditions come, it does not divert you. You don't channel your energy to haram. وَإِذَا غَضِبَ لَمْ يُخْرِجْهُ غَضَبُهُ عَنِ الْحَقِّ. And when difficulties, hardships, conditions come, when you pressed, hard pressed, then do you compromise deen? Do you leave your salah? Do you leave your tilawah? Do you leave your dhikr? Do you abandon Allah's deen when halat and conditions come? وَإِذَا قَدَرَ لَمْ يَتَنَاوَلْ مَا لَيْسَ لَهُ. And when you have an opportunity to do certain things, you do not indulge in it. So a person abstains from guna, he abstains from sin. He knows it's an opportunity, he's alone with a woman, he can commit zina, but he abstains. A message comes from a stranger, he can reply, he can engage, but he abstains. So forget matters of that, even matters of doubtfulness, he stays far away from it. Abdullah ibn Bar, rahimahullah, used to say, لَنْ أَرُدَّ دِرْهَمًا مِنْ شُبْهَةٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِنْ أَنْ أَتَسَدَّكْ بِمِئَةِ أَلْفٍ. That I abstain from one coin of doubtful matter, $1, $1 which is doubtful, abstaining from that is more beloved to me than giving $100,000 in charity and another $100,000 and another $100,000. So a person is particular about doubtful matters, they stay far. If there's doubt, some ulama say permissible, some say it's not permissible, means it's doubtful matters. He gives preference to caution. He stays away from doubtful matters. Sometimes we have to stay away from halal matters because the risk is akhirah. What's in jeopardy? What's at risk? Akhirah. Abu Darda radiallahu anhu say, tamamu taqwa. What's the completion, the culmination of taqwa? An tattaqiya ma yura annahu halal khashyata an yakuna haram. You abstain and stay away from halal, fearing that that may one day engage you in haram. Allah make us maaf. Nowadays we even find excuses to engage in haram and we use halal avenues. Somebody says, I'm giving dawat, I'm speaking to girls, ladies online, as many chats as I can, because I want to give them dawat to Allah. I want to bring them close to Allah. So in the name of deen, we justify. But if a person's taqwa, yaqeen, iman is strong, then the mind starts working on overtime. And we will never compromise our akhirat. Dhunnun Misri used to say, Man khaf Allah dhaba qalbuhu. When you got this fear of Allah, you got everything. The first thing that will happen is your heart will melt. It will melt in front of Allah, in front of the deen of Allah. Everything to do with deen, you will just fall for it. Washtadda hubbuh. And his love for Allah will increase. وَسَحَّ لَهُ لُبُّهُ And his intellect will become correct and will be rectified. So even our thought processes, our internal, external, everything will become correct when a person has the fear of Allah and it's connected to Iman. So thus Iman is not once off, not when conditions come, not when halat come, but permanently a person is desirous of Akhirah. Ulama say, أَعْذَمُ الْكَرَامَةِ لُزُومُ الْإِسْتِقَامَةِ The greatest miracle is having istiqama in consistency. فَوْقَ أَلْفِ كَرَامَةِ Istiqama is more virtuous than 1,000 miracles. So, deen is constantly, all the time, not what we deem necessary at certain times. A person came to Ibrahim bin Adham and he said, Ya Aba Ishaq, inni musarrifun ala nafsi. I have exhausted the limits in committing guna. I've done a lot of sin. I am traversed the limits, guna upon guna, musrifun ala nafsi. I've done wrong, I cannot speak about it. Give me some advice, tell me something. So Ibrahim said, إِنْ قَبِلْتَ مِنِّي خَمْسَ خِصَال If you can accept 5 qualities, then no problem. You can carry on the guna you want to do. So as if this person said, I've committed guna, now give me a way out, shortfall. I still want to commit my guna. So he's giving him advice. So he said, هَاتِ يَا أَبَا إِسْحَاقَ So he said the first thing, إِذَا أَرَدْتَ أَنْ تَعْسِيَ اللَّهِ فَلَا تَأْكُلْ مِنْ رِزْقِهِ The day you decide you want to disobey Allah, then don't eat Allah's food. So he said, where will I eat from? Everything on earth is a risk of Allah. So he asked him, is it possible you eat the risk of Allah and yet you disobey him? La wallahi, not possible. He said, give me a second advice. وَإِذَا أَرَدْتَ أَن تَأْسِيَهُ عَلَىٰ أَرْضٍ فَلَا تَسْكُنْ شَيْئًا مِّن بِلَادِهِ If you want to disobey Allah on his earth, then don't stay on his earth. So the man said, هَذَا عَذَمْ This is not possible. فَإِنَ أَسْكُنْ Where will I go? وَالْأَرْضُ وَالْبِلَادُ كُلُّهَا لِلَّهِ Everything belongs to Allah. He said, is it possible you eat the risk of Allah, you stay on Allah's earth, and you still disobey Allah? لا والله, not possible. Tell me, third advice. He said, if you want to disobey Allah, you eat from his risk, you live on his earth, you live in his house, Then فَانْذُرْ مَكَانًا لَا يَرَاكَ فِيهِ فَعْسِيهِ فِيهِ Find a place on earth where Allah is not watching you. If you find a place on earth where Allah is not watching you, then go commit guna. فَقَالَ الرَّجُلْ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ مَا هَذَا وَكَيْفَ يَكُونُ ذَلِكَ It's not possible. Allah knows everything, even what's in the hearts. He said, is it possible then? You eat from the risk of Allah, you live in his home, you commit guna where Allah is watching you clearly. He said, La wallah, I'm in error. I cannot continue like this. Give me the fourth advice. فَإِذَا جَاءَ And when the angel of death comes to take your ruh, وَأَنْتَ عَلَىٰ غَيْرِ مَا يَرْضَ اللَّهَ تَعَالَىٰ And Allah sees you, the angel of death sees you. In this condition that you loved your life incorrectly, then tell the angel of death, أَخِّرْنِي حَتَّى أَتُوبَ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَوْبَةً نَسُوهَا Give me time so that I can turn to Allah and I do good deeds. The man said that the angel of death when he comes will not delay 1 second. It's not possible. So he asked him that you eat from the risk of Allah, you live on the earth of Allah, you do guna while Allah is watching you. And you cannot delay the angel of death. Is this possible? He said, not possible. Give me the fifth advice. He said, إِذَا قُبِثْتَ عَلَى الْمَعْسِيَةِ وَأَمَرَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى بِكَ إِلَى النَّارِ وَجَاءَ الزَّبَانِيَةِ, that your ruh has been taken, the angel of punishment comes to take you to Jahannam. Don't go with him. فَلَا تَذْهَبْ مَعَهُمْ. So the man said, these are strong, powerful farishtas. They will not listen to me and I will not be able to defy that moment. So Ibrahim said, فَكَيْفَ تَرْجُنَّ جَائِذًا وَأَنْتَ عَلَى هَذِي الْهَالِ مِنَ الْمَعَاسِي وَالْغَفْلَةِ. How can you dream about salvation when you are in this condition of sin and negligence? So the man said, Ya Ibrahim, Hasbi, Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayhi. Enough, you've said enough. Your advice is a sufficient admonition. ثم تاب الرجل, he made توبة and he repented, and such a توبة he made حتى فارق الدنيا. Allah gave him tawfiq to divert and channel his energies only for Allah, and he passed away in that condition. So when a person is committing a guna or plans to commit a guna, we should make muraqabah on these 5 points. Ulama explain these 5 points mentioned. Hazrat Ibrahim bin Adham, Rahimullah, we should make muraqabah. So taqwa is very important. Busy with the topic of taqwa, 29th benefit of taqwa is the muttaqeen will inherit the earth. Allah will give them the keys to the treasures of the earth. إِنَّ الْأَرْضَ لِلَّهِ يُورِثُهَا مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the heritage of the earth to his servants who, وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ, to the muttaqeen. As we can see in the lives of Sahaba, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused a complete revolution on earth, such a revolution that if Sahaba diverted all the energies till Qiyamah, striving for dunya, they would not have gotten so much treasures on the earth and the inheritance of the earth, like how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to them when they made effort on deen. Hazrat Mughira bin Shu'bah radiallahu anhu was sent when Hazrat Nu'man bin Muqarrin, they were an expedition to Ahwaz and they requested someone to be sent. So the interpreter asked, what kind of people are you? What background do you come from? So he gave an answer to be remembered till Qiyamah. نَحْنُ نَاسٌ مِّنَ الْعَرَبِ كُنَّا فِي شَقَاءٍ شَدِيدٍ وَبَلَاءٍ طَوِيلٍ. We were plagued with misfortune and calamities. نَمُسُّ الْجِلْوَ النَّوَى. We were so hungry that we were forced to lick onto pits of dates and skin. وَلْنَلْبَسَ الْوَبَرُ وَالشَّعْرُ, that our clothing was of inferior quality. وَنَعْبُدُ الشَّجَرُ وَالْحَجَرُ, and we used to worship rocks, stones, trees. فَبَيْنَا نَحْنُ كَذَلِكَ إِذْ بَعَثَ رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَرَبُّ الْأَرْضِ إِلَيْنَا نَبِيًّا. And while we were in this condition, in the abyss of darkness, Allah, the Rabb of the heavens and earth, sent us to a Nabi from our own people who instructed us to worship this one Allah. Our Nabi also conveyed to us the message. What message? Then any of us who die while fighting Allah's path will be a Jannati and will enjoy such bounties and ni'am. ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. No eye has ever seen, no ear has ever heard, no mind can ever fathom. And those of us who survive, they will have you as their slaves. The Romans and the kings and the Persians, the US and the Europe, and the China and the superpowers of the world will be at our feet. They will become our slaves. So through deen, Allah grants inheritance and heritage of the earth. And a simple example, Hazrat Khuraym bin Aus radiallahu anhu narrates that I once migrated to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and as he was returning from Tabuk, I met him. That was when I accepted Islam. And then I heard Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam say, هذه الهيرة البيضاء قد رفعت ليه, that I have been shown the city of Hira, and in that city I've seen وَهَذِهِ الشِّمَاءُ بِنْتُ بُقَيْلَةَ الْأَزْدِيَةُ عَلَى بَغْلَةٍ شَهْبَاءَ مُؤْتَجِرَةً بِخِمَارٍ أَسْوَدٍ. And I can see vividly in front of me, in this conquest of the city, Shayma bint Buqayla from the As tribe, riding a white mule and wearing a black scarf. So I said, O Rasul of Allah, when we conquer Hira and I find her as you describe me, is she mine? Hiya lak, she's yours. She's yours. After Nabi alayhi salam passed away, it so happened that we marched to Hira with Khalid bin Walid. And the first sight as I entered the city, I seen Shayma bint Buqayla exactly how Nabi alayhi salam described. So I told Khalid bin Walid, I grabbed the mule and I said, she's mine. He said, where's your witness? So Muhammad bin Maslama and Muhammad bin Bashir from the Ansar were there. They said, we witnessed to this. Khalid gave me, handed over to me. So when he came to the treaty, then Shayma's brother Abdul Masih bin Buqayla came to me. He said, you know what, will you sell her to me? So I said, I told him in clear words that لا أنقصها والله من عشر مئة. I'll sell her to you. I will not accept less than 1,000. So he gave me 1,000 dirhams and I handed her over to him. So Sahaba people around me said, لو قلت مئة ألف لدفعها إليك. If only you ask 100,000 dirhams, he's affluent, he's rich. She's the princess of the era, she's the supermodel of the time. She's the most desired woman. How could you sell her for 1,000, even if you asked her 10,000, 50,000, even 100,000, whatever figure you call for, he would have paid it. So what the Sahabi replied, مَا كُنْتُ أَحْسَبُ أَنَّ عَدَدًا أَكْثَرَ مِنْ أَشْرِ مِئَةٍ. I did not know how to count. The highest number I could count to was 1,000. So Sahaba radiallahu anhum, apparently outwardly they were not experts with regards to even numbers, but they were experts with regards to Allah and His Rasul. And we should not get caught in this deception. Sometimes we feel we can be very knowledgeable in dunya, but we are jahil in deen. A person needs to be a'lam alim bi deenillahi. Spend time learning the deen of Allah. The rest will sort itself out, as Allah showed us what Sahaba radiallahu anhum. Whether it's the treasures of the earth, the keys of the earth, whether it's rizq from all sides, Allah will grant a person. Hatim Asam once wanted to go for Hajj and he did not have enough money for his expenses, so he was depressed in the time for Hajj nearby, and his daughter seen him hazin and baki and crying, so she inquired from his father, Ma yubika ya abata, why are you crying? He said, I need to go for Hajj. She said, but you can go. He said, Nafaqa, I don't have the money. She said, Ya Rasulullah, Allah will give you. She said, and he said, what about you people? She said, Yarzuqna Allah, Allah will provide for us, Allah will provide for you as well. He said, what about your mother? She said, don't worry, I'll sort it out. You just go for your Hajj. So they made mashwara, she convinced the mother and they gave him blessings to go for Hajj. So he left them, 3 days had passed, said he was going for Hajj. His monies were exhausted. The leader of the convoy got bitten by a scorpion. They made Alan, is anybody that knows here how to do some amal? He volunteered, he read, he got cured. And the leader said that after today, the entire travel expenses is on me. So he made dua, Allahumma hadha tadbiruka li فأرني تدبيرك لأهل بيتي. يا الله, you planned this, you sorted out my needs here, sort my needs out for my family. So meanwhile, at home, the food exhausted and they started blaming the daughter, and she was being blamed, she was laughing. So they asked, so what makes you laugh? She asked, Abuna hadha razak am akkal? Does our father give risk? Is he the, or the person who is eating the food, who's giving risk? So they said, innama razak hu Allah, only Allah gives risk. So they, she said, ذهب آكل الرزق وبقي الرزاق. The one who eats risk is gone, and the one who gives risk remains. So they didn't know what to say. As she was saying that, there was a knock on the door, and the Khalif was there at the door. He sent somebody to seek for water. They gave him water. He drank the water. He found this was the best water. He drank so sweet. He asked whose house it is. They told him that it is so and so Buzug by the name of Hatim Asam. So he said, you know what? He took out a pouch and all the jewels that he had. He said, send this as a gift, and whoever loves me will give them as well. So all his entourage also took out their belts and sent it to the house. And they were shocked when it came to the house. So when that came and they bought all their needs, then they seen the girl crying and they were all laughing. So they said, you are very strange. Kunna nabki min al-ju anti tadhakin. When we were hungry, then you were laughing. Now we've got everything, and now you are crying. So she replied that this is the creation of Allah that cannot benefit or harm. They looked at us one time with mercy, and it sufficed for us till our death, till generations. فَكَيْفَ بِمَالِكُ الْمُلْكِ. What about the Malikul Mulk, the King of Kings, the Master of Masters, O Allah? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to look at us with mercy, how much will Allah give us? So where's our attention? Where's our tawajjuh? Where's our hearts? Where's our focus? No matter what the condition, what the difficulties, what the hardships, what the tribulations, we always need to turn our attention to Allah. The amal for today is to help a Muslim brother, no matter what the situation. Whether it's giving him clothing, Allah will give him clothing in Akhirah. Whether it's food, Allah will feed him in Akhirah. Whether he's thirsty, Allah will remove his thirst in Akhirah. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ